Yo, this is your boy James over at Expecto Go, bringing you guys the latest and greatest in Wizards Unite content. And today is April 1st, which means it's April Fool's. Does not have anything to do with this video. Everything in this video is legit, okay? Coming from WB and Niantic Early Access, thank you, all that jazz, okay? Okay. It happens to also be Fred and George Weasley's birthday. But that's it. This video is about the upcoming brilliant event for the month of April, A Weasley's Predicament Part 1. So we're going to go over those details. What you guys can expect is a ton of Ibublio spell cast. A lot. But also a continuation of the story left off in March in regards to the Unforgivable and the threat to the task force and them going through with that threat with the disappearance of Ron Weasley. So this brilliant event will continue that story thread. So, yo, I'm excited about that. But without further ado, let's dive right on into the details. Now, remember, this is not an April Fool's video. This is the brilliant event guide, all that jazz. If I keep saying it's not, then it's going to feel like it is. If I have hashtag provided by WB and I can't use that hashtag unless it's like legit. So it is. All right. Speaking of which, early access provided by WB and Niantic. So shout out. Now, the details for the brilliant event for the month of April, A Weasley Predicament Part 1, are as follows. It starts April 5th through April 12th, which will be a Monday to Monday event, not a Tuesday to Tuesday event. So please do not forget that. Don't want you to start a day late. But times per usual, 11 a.m. Pacific time start and finish. And per usual, we'll have featured your 1.5 kilometer brilliant port keys and spell energy on the map, guaranteeing you 5 spell energy. Now, the foundables featured during this window, boosted during this window via the wild and tonic, are as follows. Your brilliant foundables will be brilliant proprietor George Weasley and brilliant puking pastilles. I hate that foundable, but those two will be on your map. They will be your exploration foundables, all right? And coming from fortresses using your brilliant runestone, your reward will be a brilliant Arthur Weasley looking tough with the fedora. And then coming from your port keys or your bonus rewards, if you complete the bonus assignment, your brilliant Peruvian instant darkness powder display. Yeah, that's a mouthful, but that is going to be rewarded via port keys or bonus assignment completion. And then last but not least, coming from a task, brilliant love potion stand. So those are going to be your 5 brilliant foundables found on the new brilliant page in your registry. Now, we also have some other foundables boosted to coincide with all these Ibublio tasks. And those foundables, again, boosted via the tonic and in the wild during that window, will be the Bogger Cabinet, which I actually really need. I think I just need a couple of more, and I'll have that page to gold. Then we also have the Magical Megaphone, Weasley's Fireworks, Baby Niffler, Exploding Snap Cards, and Professor Flitwick. And again, these coincide with the Ibublio task. All of these foundables have confoundables that need Ibublio. So you're going to be casting Ibublio a lot. Again, a lot of tasks. But they should help out with that and should be well boosted to help with those tasks. So speaking of which, let's dive right on into the tasks for this event. And here are the tasks you can expect to see during the brilliant event, A Weasley Predicament Part 1. Starting with task number 1, we have collect 2 ingredients and portmanteaus from your map. You'll be rewarded 6 Reen Blood. Then brew 3 potions. You'll be rewarded 2 Abraxan Hairs. And then return 12 brilliant puking pastilles. Hate that thing. You'll be rewarded 1 brew for brain elixir. Then your completion rewards are as follows. Wizarding XP, brilliant family XP, restricted books, and some spell energy. Quick tip for this one. Per usual, have some potions ready to be collected in your cauldron leading up to this event if you want to knock it out pretty fast. The normal extremely low and the healing potions have the shortest brew time. So hit those up if you want to knock it out pretty fast or stick to your normal brewing schedule. Moving on to task number 2, we have cast 13 good Ibublio spellcast. Your reward would be 4 toadstools. Then, use Mastering those 5 times, you will be rewarded 1 strong Estimulo potion. Then, return 12 brilliant proprietor George Weasley's. You rewarded 6 snowdrops, and then your completion rewards again: XP, brilliant family XP, restricted books, and spell energy. Master Notes is pretty self-explanatory, same with brilliant proprietor George, but the cast good Ibublio spells, again, those foundables I mentioned earlier will coincide with this task, so should be helpful, and you only required good. Moving on to task number 3, we have earned 7,000 wisdom XP from Traces. Your reward will be 1 strong Estimulo potion, and then collect 5 brilliant a Weasley predicament rune stones. Your reward will be 6 Bitterroot. Then, last but not least, defeat 15 foes in Wizarding Challenges. Your reward will be 1 silver key. And then again, your completion rewards XP, brilliant family XP, restricted books, and spell energy. Quick tip for this one, just make sure you have a brew for a brain elixir ready for the XP from Traces. And then 15 foes in Wizarding Challenges. Give or take, if you did like Tower 1, for example, 5 times, you usually come across 3 foes in Tower 1. You'll be able to knock that one out pretty fast. And then the runestone one, per usual, don't go into your registry until you get to this task. I have a video about trying to avoid going into your registry. I'll have that link below. And the 4th and final task we have for you guys will be cast 13 great Ibublio spells. You rewarded a spell book, earned 7,500 wisdom XP from challenges, another spell book as a reward, then collect 3 Arthur Weasley fragments from your brilliant runestones. Again, you reward another spell book. Then you complete your rewards. The last of your restricted books, the first of your Dada books, coin, spell energy, and the love potion stand. Tip for this one, again, great cast, speed over accuracy. But again, the shocking thing is the amount of great spell cast needed for this one, especially when you're going to be hanging out in Wizarding Challenges for the 7,500 Wizarding XP and trying to get Arthur Weasley fragments. So, it is what it is. I think they're slowing things down and trying to make sure we don't fly through them. I don't know. But those are the tasks you guys can expect for this event. Let's move forward to the bonus assignment. Now, for the bonus task, we have place 5 images on a brilliant a Weasley predicament page. Your reward would be 1 brew for a brain elixir. Then defeat 20 formidable foes in Wizarding Challenges. Your reward would be 10 spell energy. Earn 12,500 Wizarding XP by any source. Your reward would be 1 spell book. When in your highest chamber, unlock chamber, your reward will be 1 silver key. And then cast 20 great Ibublio spells. Your reward will be a potent Estimulo potion. Then your completion rewards, XP, brilliant XP, last of your 5 Dada books, title, spell energy, and then your port key fragment rewards. Quick tips for this one. Place 5 images on the brilliant page. Wait to place those images until you get here, per usual. The reason we suggest this is we don't want you to have to double the amount of fragments you need to return if you place it before getting to this task. So to save on spell energy and time, wait to place until you get to this task. All right, then defeat 20 formidable foes in Wizarding Challenges. Your formidable foes will be your 2-star foes in Wizarding Challenges. I have success in like ruins or tower chambers. Explore those. Particularly, I usually hit up like ruins 3 or even like tower 3. Anywhere between those, I have success. And usually it shouldn't take too long, but you never know. RNG is a thing. But 2-star foes, just look for those. And if you don't see them, you can actually run out, especially if you're using an old brilliant runestone. Then 12,500 Wizarding XP by any source. Your treasure trunks, once you rank up, will count towards that. Opening gifts will count towards that. Returning foundables will count towards that. And Wizarding Challenges will count towards that as well. But yo, that is going to be it. That is going to be it in regards to the details and some of my quick tips for the brilliant event, a Weasley Predicament Part 1. What do you guys think? How you guys feeling in regards to this event overall, task, timing, even the storyline? Comment below. Let me know. Let's talk some Harry Potter wizards unite. But yo, I'm gonna get out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching the video, hanging out with your boy. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope it was entertaining, fun, informative, helpful. If it was any of those things, drop that like. All of it helps the video and channel. So continue smashing the like button. Also, smash the subscribe button, because here we get all the latest and greatest in Wizards Unite content, gameplay, tips, news, updates, vlogs, and live streams. And a lot of the news and updates coming directly from Harry Potter Wizards Unite dev team. So, yo, make sure you smash the subscribe button and hit that notification bell. Also, follow us on the various social media, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Discord. There you can hang out with us. You get quick updates a lot quicker on those social sites than you would via video, because they take time. So follow us there if you want updates on things happening in the game, or just having some fun talking about the game, night bus sessions on weekends, all that jazz. So links will be in the description below. But yo, take care of yourselves. Again, happy April Fool's Day. And yo, enjoy your day. Be aware of any foolishness on your social media. But yo, take care of yourselves. I'll see you guys in the next video. Until